Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. All praise due to Allah alone. We praise Him. Thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. We all read in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-wise and that His wisdom has encompassed everything. His wisdom has embraced everything in this universe. And one of the wisdoms of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala behind decreeing tribulations, hardships, and difficulties, and calamities is that for us to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For us to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. For us to establish a stronger connection with Allah ta'ala, the Almighty. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. Why not when our calamity befalls on them? Why they did not return to Allah? Why they have not humbled themselves and returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ. And we trialed them with that which is good and that which is hard and evil and bad. Why? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So they may return back to us and repent back to us, subhanAllah. So one of the wisdoms behind tribulations, hardships, and difficulties, and calamities in our lives is for us to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and establish a stronger connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. This Ramadan can be a golden opportunity for us, a golden chance for us to strengthen our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. We can turn this calamity into a great opportunity, a great chance to have the best and the most beautiful relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, by doing few important points. We can start Ramadan with a sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the Quran. Allah ta'ala advises us to repent to Him and return back to Him in a constant manner. Allah ta'ala said,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا.
Oh, you believe, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sincere repentance. Allah ta'ala is calling the believers, not the wrongdoers, not the evildoers, but the believers. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا, repent to Allah.
تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا.
Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sincere repentance. The ulama said, this could indicate that we should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only from the sins, not only from our wrongdoing, we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also from our shortcomings in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say that I indeed repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times a day. I seek forgiveness more than 70 times a day. So repent to Allah Ta'ala and return back to Allah Ta'ala, the Almighty. Let's begin Ramadan with a sincere repentance to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, the Almighty. Let's get our hearts upright, because the sins will cause our hearts to be turned upside down. So the guidance, the revelation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will not touch it, will not affect it. Once the hearts are upright, then the hearts will become receptive to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that will return our hearts to become upright, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنْ تَابَ وَعَادَ سُقِلَ قَلْبُهُ. If he repented to Allah and returned back to Allah, his heart will return back as it was. The second advice, reconciliation with the people, with your relatives, with your brothers, with your fellow Muslims. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the sound hadith that, shall I tell you an action that is better than the salah and zakah and siyam? Ala adullukum ala amalin afdala min as-salati was-sadaqah was-siyam. The ulama said, he means the voluntary صيام, the voluntary salah, the voluntary zakah, charity. The Sahaba said this, of course, Ya Rasulullah, tell us, what is better than this? And the answer was, صلاح ذات البين, reconciliation with people, reconciliation between people, reconciliation with your relatives, your brothers, your fellow Muslims. Then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, verily, the bad relationship between you and your fellow Muslim is the razor that will erase your religion, your entire religion, subhanAllah. In the other hadith, he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, it won't erase, it won't shave, it won't shave your hair, but it will shave your deen, your religion, subhanAllah. And that's why the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم in the other hadith said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the actions will be shown to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every Monday and every Thursday. And Allah ta'ala will say for those who are having a bad relationship between them, Allah ta'ala will say, leave them until they reconcile. Until they reconcile. So for our actions to be shown to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're going to work hard in Ramadan, we'll try our best. But imagine that you do your best, you pray, you fast, and you give in charity, but your actions are not shown to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the benefit? So make sure that we reconcile with the people as much as we can. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said that when he was asked, how were you receiving Ramadan? He said, radiallahu anhu arzah, he said, no one of us would dare to receive Ramadan and he has in his heart a shred of hatred towards his Muslim brother. So let's begin with a, يعني, inshallah ta'ala, a complete and comprehensive reconciliation with our Muslim brothers. The last point that I would like to emphasize on, or the last advice that I would like to emphasize on, is to renew our connection with the Quran. Subhanallah. This Quran is the main source of guidance, is the main source of direction, the main source of inspiration. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said,
إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ.
Indeed, this book guides towards that which is the straightest. Not the straight path, but the straightest path. The most just and the most right path. In every issue, in every dilemma, in every confusion, this book will guide you towards the straightest path.
إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات.
And this book will give glad tidings for the believing, for the believers who are doing good deeds. So it will encourage you, to motivate you, subhanallah. Just read it and have a connection with it.
أن لهم أجرا كبيرا.
It will motivate you and gives you what Allah Ta'ala has promised you of good, of great reward in the day of judgment by His grace subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Ta'ala revealed it for a purpose, not to recite it, not to read it, to ponder on it, to reflect upon it. The reason why Allah Ta'ala revealed it is for us to read it, reflect upon it, and take it into practice.
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته.
This book which we have revealed to you is full of blessings, full of guidance. And the reason why we revealed it to you is for them to ponder on its verses.
وليتذكر أولو الألباب.
And men of understanding may reflect, may take it into practice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to do so. So inshallah ta'ala, let's turn this calamity into a golden opportunity. Let's revive the Quran in our houses. Let's revive the voluntary salah in our houses. Let's pray tarawih with our family. Let's strengthen the connection between us and the bonds between us and our children and our family. Let's inshallah ta'ala make it one of the best Ramadans in our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all wise. There is the wisdom behind what's happening now. There is a wisdom behind this pandemic. It could be that Allah Ta'ala wants from us to return back to Him collectively, all of us. To know that He is the one who's master in everything. It's a chance for us to have Ramadan in such environment. Let's utilize it and let's inshallah ta'ala take the best advantage of it. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and to reward you all, the viewers of Huda TV. And I ask Allah ta'ala to enable you to have this Ramadan or to make this Ramadan one of your best Ramadans. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.